Welcome to another exciting edition of the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast. I am your MC, Davo. With me today, we have Kells.
Hello there.
We have Twi.
It's-a me.
We have Andy.
Hello, Ladle Brainers.
And we have the Sensei Me.
Excuse me, Randy. It's my turn. Hey, everybody.
Hi.
Do you guys want to play a game of trivia?
I would love to.
Let's do it.
So let me go over the rules just in case you forgot. Each week we have a theme. Within that theme, we've got six categories, four questions each. Each question is worth 10 points. Maybe a few bonus points thrown in here and there. And then a final, which is worth up to 100 points. And today's theme is yet another mystery. So the way the mysteries work, mystery themes work, is each category has kind of a mini theme to it. If you put those six mini themes together, it should get you to the final, to the overall theme. And the first person to send me a message with the overall theme will get a bonus 20 points. Second place will get 15 and so on. And you only get one guess, so make it count. But I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to tell you the broad category for the theme, because I think sometimes the themes are a little bit too hard, or the mystery themes are too hard. So this is a movie.
Me.
All right. So the mystery movie.
The mystery is a movie. Okay.
And at the halfway point, I'll give you an additional hint.
Whoa.
Love it.
Okay.
This is a new, gentler sensei. It's weird.
Well, I just want to see how it works out. Because, like, I know Twi basically never answers the mystery themes. So I'm hoping that this will give her a little bit of a help.
Yeah.
I
thought this was completely out of left field.
Halfway through, so I don't care.
Wow. Okay.
I get it now.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I love Twi. She truly is the best of us.
Yeah. I didn't grow up with this New Testament sensei. I was the Old Testament sensei. Yeah.
All right. Category one. So I'm going to play some audio clips.
Okay. Ooh.
I'll give you a date, and you need to tell me the two teams that are involved in the audio clip.
Okay.
You'll get it when you hear them. So question one is from August 4th, 1993.
Well, you can see that Nolan was hitting Robin right on the top of his head, so he probably hurt his hand a little bit in that thing, and he did get one good lick in on an uppercut.
Oh, he played for so many teams.
Yeah.
I'm locked in. Educated guess.
There were two names in there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'm locked in.
And by the way, for all of these, I'll give you 5 points for each team that you get correct.
Twi's gone to the library again.
Locked in.
All right. Let's start with Kels.
I said the Rangers and the White Sox.
Deva?
Rangers and White Sox.
Andy?
Shoot, I went with the wrong Robin. I went with the Brewers and the Rangers.
Oh, Yount?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I went with Robin Yount. I didn't think of the other Robin.
Twi?
Astros and the Braves.
Correct answer are the Rangers and the White Sox. It was Nolan Ryan and Robin Ventura. And I think at the time, Nolan was like 42 years old, and he just beat the crap out of that kid.
headlock,
wailing on him, headlock, and giving him the noogies.
Yeah, the noogies. He was pounding him on the top of the head.
Yeah, he's giving him really, really vicious noogies.
Aggressive.
Okay, wait.
Robin Ventura looked good as he approached the mound, and that was the last moment he looked good in that fight.
All baseball fights start that way. They look awesome approaching. Then they, about halfway to home plate, they're like, wow, I'm really going to punch this guy. What am I going to do? And they just kind of bounce off of each other, and then they all pile on, and it's a big, it's nothing. Yeah,
pull apart brawl.
Yeah. Just.
Okay. So it's Nolan Ryan and Robin Ventura. I got to go to YouTube later and look at this fight. Okay.
Oh, it's worth it.
It's the old man beat up a really young.
If you think that one's
who fine, was it that knocked over Popeye? That was
why don't you just wait for the rest of the questions?
Oh, okay.
maybe at the end of the category you can ask that, and we'll see what happens.
Okay. Interestingly. All right.
Question two.
And now Chanhol Park, with one on and one out, shows bunt, and he drops it again down beautifully. Belcher will field and tag him out. Second time that Park has moved the runner, and now some shoving, and a fight breaks out between Belcher and Park, and Park kicks Belcher, and both benches will empty.
Ooh.
I remember this one locked in.
That's right.
Have a question. It has nothing to do with this answer. But isn't Chanhol Park like the first Korean baseball player in MLB? Was that his claim to fame?
It might be.
Okay.
I'll check.
No, I just remember his name sounds familiar, and I think that's the reason why.
Yeah.
Yes, he was the first South Korean-born player in Major League history.
Okay. I ran across that doing sports. I didn't
know. No, that's
coincidentally also the first South Korean player to be named to the named as an All-Star.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I know now. All right. A trivia nugget.
Locked in.
Okay. Okay. Dave.
Believe it's the Reds and the Dodgers.
Andy?
Crap. I thought it was Dodgers Angels.
That's why.
Padres and the Dodgers.
Kels?
I said Dodgers versus Padres.
Correct answer, Dodgers and the Angels.
Oh,
nice. I thought the announcer, I was trying to go with the announcer. I wasn't sure who Belcher played for.
Had no idea.
I thought the announcer was Marty Brenneman. And that was
That wasn't Marty Brenneman. I recognize he was a Cubs announcer for a long time.
Brenneman was a Cubs guy?
Yeah, Marty Brenneman was a Cubs guy back.
Harry Carey.
Well, Harry Carey
died. Had nothing to do with me, but he died.
He was dead before the show even started.
Yeah, way before I harnessed my powers.
Died spelled backwards is dead. How about that, Stoney?
Okay, here's question three.
Don Zimmer and Pedro Martinez. Oh, that's awful. Don Zimmer, a 72-year-old man, went into Pedro Martinez's face, and Pedro Martinez threw him down.
Sorry, everybody. I lost my head.
I've got opinions about this. I'm locked
in. I was going to say... I am sure, you know, pushing around elderly men is going to be defended by
locked in.
Can't wait to hear.
You're about to.
That elderly national treasure had it coming.
National treasure my ass.
Are we all locked in?
Mm-hmm.
I believe so.
Okay, Andy.
Yankees, Red Sox.
Twy.
Boston and the Yankees.
Kels.
Red Sox v. Yankees.
And Diva.
Red Sox versus Yankees.
The correct answer is Yankees, Red Sox.
And moving on, question four.
No, moving on. John Zimmer got in a fight. He ran out there and got in a fight and was John with another person.
I'm sure Pedro Martinez wishes he could take that back, but at the same time, I am going to begrudgingly say that Devo is absolutely right.
Oh, yeah.
Popeye came out of the dugout and got right into Pedro's face.
Right up in his face.
Who was right into his face?
Who was Red Sox? Who was Yankee?
Pedro was Red Sox, and okay. Don Zimmer was a bench coach.
Yankees. The Cubs had just let him go as a manager, and he was bench coaching for the Yankees.
And he comes waddling out of the dugout during a brawl.
Whoa!
There was no need to say waddling.
I want to make this clear. If Pedro Martinez was pitching for the Yankees,
yeah,
and Popeye was a Red Sox bench coach, you would be defending Popeye. I would say right
if
now.
You're 72 years old with bad knees, don't jump in a brawl at a baseball game. Doesn't matter who. A
national treasure.
National treasure. Good Lord. And he was a Red Sox manager at one point, too.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh.
In the 70s.
Oh, jeez.
There's no connection. We get it's more his time.
Oh, gosh.
So what I learned is baseball is a sport where the people who aren't playing need a coach.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy, isn't it?
Are they being coached on how to sit?
They employ a lot of good people.
You gotta put the left over the right, not the right over the left. Sit on the bench.
He's actually coaching the bench.
Oh, okay.
He's actually coaching the bench.
Well, at 72, it's probably about all he can handle, right?
It's still there. Yo, Skip, the bench hadn't moved since the fourth inning. Should I warm her up? Nah, it's fine, Don. You're okay. Why don't you fill out this lineup card for me?
Oh, gosh. All right. And finally, this is from, I don't know if I've been saying the dates. This is from April
11th, 2018.
There is a melee on the infield. Nolan Arenado had a ball go behind him. He threw his helmet down, ran toward the pitcher's mound. Perdomo threw his glove down. Bench is cleared. Here come the bullpens as well.
One more time.
And the band's on the field. Oh, I'm sorry. I just was going to keep going with that call.
I watched a lot of these. I think this is the one where the guy took his batting helmet off and you could see him about to throw it, and I thought, man, he's going to throw that right at the pitcher. But, of course, he throws it off to the side because he doesn't really want to get in trouble. he just wants to go up there and push and shove a little bit.
Yeah, nobody
that's not wants the way the brawls used to be. I remember watching one from the 70s where this guy did a flying karate kick into the guy's stomach. What? I ran up and kicked him square in the stomach.
That'll get the party started.
Juan Marichal actually took a bat out to the pitcher. He was running at him with a bat.
That's scary.
Yeah.
I'm drawing a total blank on this one.
I'm locked.
I got it. I'm gonna go with this.
I know Nolan for sure. But
do you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I think all of these were on the Major League Baseball's best fights or something like that.
Wow.
I'm locked in.
Twy, what's your answer?
Mets and Braves.
Kels?
Rockies and the Padres.
Deva? You think the Padres start a lot of mess, don't you, bud?
Why not?
I said the Rockies and the Marlins.
Andy?
I said the Tigers and the Twins. No idea.
Correct answer is the Rockies and the San Diego Padres.
Oh, they did it. Those stinking Padres.
What was great is the chicken got into that fight, and that was epic.
At the end of category one, Twy has 15, Andy 25, Devo 30, and Kels 35. So we move on to category two. Question one, Clive Campbell was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2023 in the musical influence category. He is sometimes called the father of hip hop and was influential in developing the break on turntables. What is his stage name?
Locked In.
Locked In.
We all know what you want to say, Dave. Just say it.
Yeah, I'm just say it. Just get it out there.
You're not allowed to say it.
No. Say it. I'm not going to say it.
You could be right.
I turned my headphones the wrong way. It was like one headphone on, one headphone off. What's going on? Like a DJ. Yeah. I'm going to say this to try to impress my friends who like hip hop.
Well, we're both listening.
Yes.
I'm afraid.
No, it's a real thing, I swear.
Okay. Ready? Let's start with Davo.
Terminator X.
Ooh. I like it. Okay. I like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Andy.
Downtown DJ McBee.
No.
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 No. Downtown no. Sherman.
Come on.
No.
Twy.
DJ Cool Herc.
Cool Herc?
DJ Cool Herc.
Cool Herc as in Hercules.
Herc.
Yeah.
I thought you said Hurt.
Like, no, Herc.
Okay.
And Cool as in the gang.
Right.
Yeah, and started, it was K-O-O-L.
Oh, that okay. I gave myself 10 points for Terminator X, by the way. I'll just scratch
okay,
that.
Well, yeah.
Wow.
Just
put that zero on. I felt such good adulation. I was like, yes, that's 10 points. Hooray.
Question two. After befriending the Beatles in the early years of Beatlemania, a radio personality was sometimes referred to as the fifth Beatle. His name was Murray the what?
Probably a party that you don't want to attend, but you're locked in.
That's how I'm okay. locking in.
I think
baby.
Andy's locked in.
Yeah, I would presume. Oh,
no, Murray's opportunity slipped through my fingers. Cup of coffee, man. Yeah, man. Man. I have no idea what this answer is.
Neither do I.
Some dude named Murray.
Murray the what? Okay.
I'm gonna... big-time big guy, yeah. But in comparison to the Macho King, you're not even one grain of sand in the Sahara Desert.
No, I am not. The entire desert.
I'm locked in.
You know every next line. That is yes. creepy. How do you do that?
It's called wasting your life watching Macho Man promos.
I'm locked in.
Am I the only one that finds him really, really annoying?
The Macho Man? Yeah.
I hate wrestling and sir? I love the Macho Man.
I'm sure you're not, but man, it's hard to
think. The Macho Man's giant hat was made entirely of cocaine. A lot of people don't know that.
80s wrestlers using cocaine?
Oh.
Jeez. Are we all locked in?
I'm locked in.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay, wait, I was waiting for that to a slip, Jill.
Let's start with Andy.
Murray the K.
Twy.
What?
Murray the Mac.
Kels.
Murray the Termite.
And Deva.
Anybody tell you the story about Murray the Moocher?
Many! Many!
Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Oh, God.
Was that your answer, Moocher?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure if I'd ever heard Murray the K in my life, I would remember it.
Well, then you don't listen to enough Beatles trivia. His name was Murray Kaufman, known as Murray the K.
He was really like the classic obnoxious rock DJ of the early 60s. He was god awful. No.
Murray the K, obnoxious.
I know him from the only reason I knew that is from a Dictator song called Who Will Save Rock and Roll.
Oh, does he make an appearance?
Yeah.
He was a big deal.
Well, no, he doesn't. They refer to him.
Yeah. Reference.
Yeah. Question three. The actress who played the oldest child on the show Full House is the sister of what other 80s child star?
Locked in.
Oh. Andy, you remember? She was in Murphy Brown. She played Murphy Brown.
June the 6th in the Boston Gardens. I'm going to tell you something now. It's a secret, but you can tell everybody that there's going to be a fight. Yeah. Ric Flair versus the Macho Man Randy Savage.
That's the wrong one. Sorry, I didn't want to hit that one. That was a dumb one. Ric Flair versus the
Man. That's a good match.
I'll come back later with a good one.
Oh, boy.
I'm excited. Yeah.
Why?
Kirk Cameron.
Kels.
Kirk Cameron.
Deva.
Kirk Cameron.
And Andy.
Kirk Cameron.
It is Kirk Cameron. And question four. What early rock and roll radio personality was the original voice for Scooby-Doo and for Robin in the Super Friends cartoon?
Yeah, locked in right away.
Oh, I didn't realize he was the voice of Robin.
He was.
Sorry.
What are you doing?
I'm just trying to get the next clip ready to go. This is hard.
I'm locked in.
Kels?
Casey Kasem.
Deva?
Casey Kasem.
Andy?
Casey Kasem.
And Twy?
Casey Kasem.
It's Casey Kasem. All right. Ooh. So did you guys ever watch that show Cheers?
Yes.
Do you remember that?
Yeah,
Carla's ex-husband had this really tall, pretty, blonde new wife. Do you remember her?
I remember her.
That's Casey Kasem's wife.
Was it really?
Really? Yeah. Hmm.
I forget. I don't know her name.
Mrs. Kasem.
Yes. I think it was Gene Thompson Kasem. I think I remember them because they both, I think they were stumping for, it would have been 1988. I think they were campaigning for Jesse Jackson. He came to my university to do a speech. And wow. I think Casey Kasem introduced him.
Wow.
Anyway, that is not relevant to anything. So let's carry on. Oh, scores. Scores. Twy has 45, Devo 50, Andy 55, and Kel 65. Which brings us to category three. Question one. Who is the current senior senator from Massachusetts?
Oh, no. Yes? All right. I have a guess.
Ted Kennedy's dead, right?
Yeah.
Just checking.
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in too.
For anybody who's listening to us like 10, 15 years from now, we're recording this in
2014. Whoa. 2014.
2014,
I would have been right.
Some Casey Kasem died.
I got Kasem on the brain.
I'm locked in.
I think we're all locked in.
Are we? Okay, Andy.
Kind of sounded British when you said that.
Oh, did I?
Well, tally-o.
A little less British now.
I just thought Neil wanted to move along the show. I was just trying to help.
No, I appreciate that, Andy. That's what you're known for, is moving the show along.
Moving things along.
Andy, what's your answer?
Water out. Sorry.
I am not... I know Elizabeth Warren is the senator from Massachusetts, but I'm not sure if she's the senior senator from Massachusetts, but I'm going with Elizabeth Warren.
Okay. Twy?
Elizabeth Warren.
Kels?
I also said Elizabeth Warren.
And Dave?
Miss Elizabeth Warren.
It is Senator Elizabeth Warren.
Did you get my little Randy Macho Man Savage reference there, Kels?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, I see. You said Miss Elizabeth, right?
Uh-huh, because she's married. She's not a miss.
Oh. Oh, yeah, that's great.
Question two. Who is known as the Blood Countess or Countess Dracula?
Locked in.
I had a feeling David would get this one.
I am going to punt. I have no idea.
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
Let's start with Twy.
Elizabeth.
Kills.
Lizzie Borden.
Deva.
Bathory.
And Andy.
By using Ray Guy's techniques, every punter can consistently create a spiral. This aerodynamic rotation promotes greater distance and increases hang time.
The correct answer is Elizabeth Bathory. She was accused of killing as many as 600 girls from the local village in, I don't know, when was that, like the 1200s or something like that, a long time ago. And I don't know. She was convicted and basically held for the rest of her life in house arrest in her big giant castle on a hill.
Well, you're burying the lead there, buddy.
Oh yeah, she was accused at one point of bathing in the blood of the girls that she killed.
Oh.
Specifically virgins.
Yeah.
Oh. Hmm.
I think it was politically motivated. I don't think she actually did that. But what do I know? Records aren't very good. They didn't take like photographs and stuff.
So. Yeah. There's no DNA evidence. How could she be proven guilty?
Question 3. How many years did Elizabeth II reign?
All of them.
I'll take 2 points off for every year that you're off.
I should know this.
You would think, huh?
I'm going to say the first 20 years is just kind of a blur of bourbon and bad ideas.
What about the next 20?
Got fun.
Man, it was so long.
I'm locked in.
Locked in.
I'm locked in.
Let's start with Kels.
71 years.
Deva?
I said 75.
Andy?
It was 70 years and I'm ready for 70 more.
You're ready for 70 more? Well, I hate to break it to you.
The Muppets present Queen Elizabeth.
Twy.
70 years.
The correct answer is 70 years.
Ah, fart. I get no points.
Crap. You do. Kells gets 8. Andy and Twy get 10.
See, I thought that you do was like, oh, no way, buddy.
Right.
You do get points.
Nope. That's what I thought he was saying, too, but then no. Nope.
Then no. It was 2 points.
It was like a shame switcheroo.
It was. I felt like a shame switcheroo.
I didn't aim for that, but I really like the sound of it.
I'll have to
work on them. Shame switcheroo.
He's got a new move. He needed a new move.
Can't get stale, man.
Question 4. According to the children's rhyme, how many total whacks did Lizzie Borden deliver?
Locked in.
Locked in.
I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. Deva?
80.
Oh.
Andy?
40 whacks and 40 more for 80.
Twy?
40.
And Kels?
Say 13.
When and how you sweep is a vital part of curling.
Don't feel bad.
Lizzie Borden took an axe and gave her mother 40 whacks. And when she saw what she had done, she gave her father 41.
I thought it was 41 more. God. Fart sandwich. Oh, come on.
Maybe there's a different version of the rhyme.
Dave, I think you grew up with the remix.
So according to Encyclopedia Britannica, it would be 81.
I guess I just heard 40 more and just went with it. I don't know. I just always heard it that way, but I'm clearly wrong. It's okay.
Is this a nursery rhyme?
Yeah.
It's not a pleasant one.
Clearly.
I've heard it more to my grandchildren.
When I read about it, it's more of a children's skipping rope rhyme.
Yeah.
Okay.
And those get dark. Those fucking kids on skip rope are dark.
Yeah. You're correct there, whoever. Yeah. I'm wrong.
Are you still investigating? Yeah, he's still. You still hadn't given up on that.
No, I was trying to figure out why I heard it as 40 more.
I'm trying to figure out how you're so well versed in the song. Like, this is really troubling you. I was pleased I was close.
Yeah, she didn't actually do that many. Even if she did do the crime, which she was acquitted of, but it was more like 13 and 18 to the two parents.
No fiddle. Okay.
All right. At the end of category three, Twy has 65, Devo 70, Andy 75, and Kells 83. So we are at the halfway point. I'll give a second if anybody wants to make any guesses, and then I'll give kind of an additional clue to the theme. If
are we messaging you through Discord or?
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
All right, so an additional clue is this is considered a cult classic movie.
Cult classic.
Ooh. So, I'm on the wrong track then. I'm glad I didn't guess.
Good. Okay, we're going to
almost guessed and I...
Hold, please.
Don't.
Hold, please.
I was thinking, and it's going to make me lose my train of thought. Okay,
oh, now ahead. We have to be quiet when Twy's thinking.
You didn't have to.
Holy shit.
Where's your Randy Newman impression? You have to use that.
Category four. We've got literature tribons.
Son of a motherless goat.
I'm going to give you three characters from a novel or series of novels, and you tell me what the novel or series of novels is.
Okay.
Question one. Violet, Klaus, and Sunny.
Locked in.
Locked in.
I'm going to punt.
Wish I could. I don't know this.
It's one of those I'm going to feel bad about punting.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Dang it! Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait.
Okay, we're waiting. Okay.
No, I'm still punting.
Wow.
Andy, did you lock in? Climactic.
Yeah, I'm locked in.
Okay. Twy.
Lemony Snicket's A Series of Unfortunate Events.
Come on,
Andy.
The phone book.
Boom. Now Ray Guy comes
that's for Darrow.
First punt of the day. Kick us away. There's a high twisting hang time spiral.
And Kels.
A Series of Unfortunate Events.
The correct answer is A Series of Unfortunate Events.
I think you mean to say one of the correct answers. The other correct answer is The Phone Book,
which is
what's a phone
which
book?
It's not a novel.
Well, this depends on how much spare time you have and how bored you are. It's like a novel in kit form. All the characters are there.
Kit.
You just gotta find a plot.
So, David, was that exclamation you made because you should have known it, or because there's no way you were gonna know it?
I never read any of the books, but I watched the series on Netflix.
Yeah.
And I got hung up on a different book. Mm-hmm. So that was my...
Well, that happens sometimes. Question two. Miss Havisham, Estella, Pip.
Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in?
Wait, characters one more time, please.
Miss Havisham, Estella, Pip.
Stella!
Dave, I'll give you a hint for a fourth character. Thing two.
Locked in.
Twy, did you lock in?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Andy?
Great Expectations.
Deva?
Pippi Longstockings.
Kels?
Great Expectations.
That's why you were being really Great generous by giving us one of the characters.
the Charles Dickens classic. Pippi Longstockings.
Yeah.
The early dark pre-book on Pippi Longstocking starving on the streets of London.
It is Great Expectations. Question three. Anne Shirley, Marilla Cuthbert, and Gilbert Blythe.
Oh.
Locked in.
Oh, yeah.
Anne Shirley.
God, it sounds familiar, but I can't come up with it.
It does.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. Gilbert Blythe is clearly a superhero's alter ego. That is definitely.
Plastic Man.
This comic book writes itself.
I'm a lock in.
And his sidekick, Tester Smint.
Deva.
Anne of Green Gables.
Kels.
Anne of Green Gables.
Twy.
Anne of Green Gables.
Andy.
The Big Book of Baby Names.
It is Anne of Green Gables.
And?
They don't give you last names too in the Big Book of Baby Names.
Well, yeah, I got nothing.
Well, actually, except for Cuthbert, there's Anne Shirley, Gilbert Blythe, and Marilla Cuthbert. I don't know. Those might all be first names, too.
Depends on the year.
I'll take the points and the apology. Thank you.
Nope. You're getting neither because, again, not a novel.
Andy's really trying, though, and I appreciate it.
I do. I'll give him an attaboy for his.
He's working hard for those points.
I got nothing on these.
How about on question four, we've got Jane Porter, Kala, and William Clayton.
Oh, William Clayton.
Locked in?
Yeah.
And it wasn't Yellow Submarine a book?
It was barely a movie.
The movie was based on the book.
Locked in.
I know this name. Locked in, sure.
All right, we'll start with Kels.
Tarzan.
Twy.
Tarzan.
Andy.
The Great Shark Hunt by Hunter S. Thompson.
And Devo.
Tarzan.
Or Tarzan. Tarzan. So Jane Porter, obviously, is Jane. Kala was the ape that adopted Tarzan, and William Clayton is like the antagonist, I guess. Tarzan's cousin or something.
I don't know. I only saw the movie once.
All right. At the end of category four, we've got Andy with 85, Devo 90, Twy 105, and Kels 123. So we're moving on to category five. Question one. What birds are in the genus Cygnus? C-Y-G-N-U-S.
Well, you got your Larry birds.
Your lady birds.
Your lady birds. Locked Thorn in. Birds. Locked in.
Locked in.
Locked in.
All right. Andy.
Penguins.
Deva.
Crow.
Kels.
Swans.
Twy.
Swans.
Swans.
There's the first bleep.
First one.
Sorry. It just came out.
Your Patreon money at work. Those cost is like $5 a piece. You could have bought a Cadillac Seville by now. But you have to have a potty mouth.
Question two here was edited by a very close friend of the show and our accountant.
Yay!
So I'll give you a clue what it's about.
Mythology.
Swans.
Question two. Who competed with Odysseus for the honor of wearing Achilles' armor after his death, only to commit suicide after being defeated?
Sounds like the plot of the song Beat It. No one wants to be defeated.
There's no way I'm going to have an answer now. Why did you do that?
I have no idea about the answer.
That's as good as I got.
Oh, no.
Somebody's got to get this right or else we look like idiots.
Can I hear the question one more time?
Who competed with Odysseus for the honor of wearing Achilles' armor after his death, only to commit suicide after being defeated?
Mm. Oh, that's right. Odysseus looked at him and said, "Don't want to see your face, you better disappear." I remember that.
Andy. Don't you ever come around here.
Okay.
Yeah, the fire's in their eyes.
The words are very clear.
Really clear.
Come on.
Dave-O, you got this. Just show them that you're really not scared.
That's one of those songs that I've heard a million times, and I don't actually know any of the words.
Wow.
Except the chorus.
Yeah.
I get it. I mean, they'll kick you and they'll beat you and they'll tell you it's fair. So.
Oh, you guys are
showing
just
how funky and strong is it.
The only answer I'll be able to pull is the dude in the white coat in the shades from the
Right?
I got nothing.
No. I remember there were kids in my neighborhood that were talking about how he used real gang members in that video. And even as, I'm probably like 12.
Just between you and me, can you just mute those motherfuckers real quick?
You can take your headphones off for a second.
Jeez Louise.
He wants to hear it, though.
You know what, Dave-O? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'll be quiet. No one wants to be defeated. I'm sorry.
Come on.
It's just a game. It doesn't matter who's wrong or right.
This is just out of my headphones. Going down.
Andy's in the pocket. I love it.
Andy, I think what Dave-O's trying to say is beat it. Just beat it.
I get it. I'm sorry.
In case you didn't hear me, I'm locked in.
Okay. I think we're just waiting for Dave-O.
I'm locked in too.
They'll kick you and they'll beat you, Dave-O, and then they'll tell you it's fair.
It's like saying the dudes from West Side Story were in a real gang.
I know. Because your gang members got the choreography. It was very common for your street games to work on the choreography.
Still?
everybody be quiet. Dave-O don't want to be a boy. He wants to be a man.
I'm like,
that might be one of our best bits ever.
It was really good, but my wife wrote this question, so I would like to get it right.
All right, we good?
Sure.
Let's start with Dave-O.
Hector.
Kels.
Ooh. Stoney Jackson.
Why?
Ajax.
And Andy.
Oh. Billie Jean.
One of you got it right.
Ajax.
Good job, Andy.
Thank you.
No, it was Ajax.
Oh. Yeah, that's what I said.
Oh,
Hector would have been dead by then, right?
Because
Achilles killed him.
Why don't you all? You all. Even you, Twy, because you managed to fight through that crap.
Question three. What artist created masterpieces such as The Anatomy Lesson of Dr. Nicholas Tulp, The Hundred Guilder Print, and The Night Watch?
Locked it.
Oh, The Night Watch? Oh, it's Nighthawks.
It's Nighthawks.
Yeah, it's very different pictures.
Yeah.
I don't know this one either.
Ladin?
I got it.
No, I don't want to be the only dumb one again.
Like Mike wasn't in either one of those gangs, but he went there to break it up.
He is the guy he was. He's not the hero we deserve, but the hero we need.
He took his time getting ready.
why did he go into the diner?
To show off the moves.
Yeah, that didn't have anything to do with the scene of the crime.
It's like he was a detective, like, retracing his steps.
Of somebody having a seizure.
Yeah. Like, this pool table is still warm. They were just here.
All right, I'm locked in with a guess.
All right. Start with Kels.
Rembrandt.
Holy sh! Really?
Twine?
Maybe.
Rembrandt?
Really?
Andy?
I don't know what the other paintings are, but I love the Night Watch. It's Rembrandt.
Holy crap! Devo. Rembrandt!
It's Rembrandt.
Whoa!
There was a clue in there. If you didn't know the Night Watch, I thought the 100 Guilder print might put you in mind of a Dutch painter. And mm-hmm. he's like the Dutch That's painter.
Of course, how I got it. Yeah. Sussed out the clue.
That painting, by the way, is massive. It is huge.
Mm-hmm. Is it really?
Yeah, I saw it once in Amsterdam, and it takes up like an entire wall.
Ooh. Wow.
Question 4. What fictional FBI detective was obsessed with finding the cause of his sister's mysterious disappearance?
Locked in.
Locked in.
I don't know what this category is.
I don't even know what this dude was in the FBI, but let's do it. I'm locked in.
Let's do this. Like just after this, it's go out Popeye tipping.
You deserved it, the old man.
Find some elderly Yankee managers in a bar.
Knock his ass
push
over.
Push him over.
Boom. Try to get up now, Gramps.
Twy.
Mulder.
Andy.
Agent Mulder.
Deva.
Mulder.
And Kels.
Fox Mulder.
Correct answer is Fox Mulder.
I figured he was an X-Man.
From the X-Files.
Oh, I loved that show.
Me
oh,
too.
My God.
Yeah, apparently
I was
his,
all over that.
When he was, his older sister, when she was like 12 or 13, disappeared mysteriously. And for some reason, he assumed it was like some supernatural thing. And so he devoted his entire life to finding the supernatural reasons for his sister's disappearance.
Well, because because his sister was abducted by aliens. Because
well, it turns out
father
yeah.
was. Yeah, I mean, come on.
Oh, well, spoiler alert. I hadn't seen it, Andy.
It never gets resolved. It's genuinely Speed Racer's brother X. It's the same thing.
It's Racer X all over
again. It's Racer X all over again.
At the end of category 5, Andy has 105, Devo 110, Twy 145,
God.
And Kels 153.
God!
I just want one chance to put my hands on your ugly face, yeah. I just want one chance to put my hands on your ugly face, yeah.
There you go. That's how I feel. Yeah, you know, the Patreon dollars for this was well worth it.
And our final category. Question 1. Which New York City borough is not primarily on an island?
Oh. I always get these ones wrong.
Me too.
Locked in?
It's probably not Staten Island. try to eliminate that one quick. All right, I got one.
I don't under...
Locked in.
Deva?
Queens.
Kels?
Said Brooklyn.
Twy?
The Bronx.
Andy? Wow.
I went with Queens.
Not correct. One of you got it right. It is the Bronx. So obviously Staten Island is an island. Manhattan is an island. Queens and Brooklyn are both on the western end of Long Island.
Oh. And
the Bronx is north of Manhattan on the mainland.
See, I knew when I guessed Queens it was wrong, because if Queens is right, then Brooklyn has to be right.
Right.
But I couldn't come up with anything else.
I knew I was wrong because Andy agreed with me.
Thanks, Dave.
We're bringing up the rear, homeboy.
Yeah, I know. We are the unwanted stepchildren in this family. Sensei is so proud of Kels and Twilight.
Question two. What English explorer was the first to map the island of Manhattan?
That's an interesting question.
Locked in. I already made my guess on the theme. I'm doing terrible. I don't really care anymore.
Wow.
Damn.
That's right.
I broke Devo.
That's right.
I'm locked in.
I've given up. In. You broke my spirit, Dad. How you like that? I'll go to business school after all. I just wanted to be a rock star. But no, I had to be smart like Kels or charming like Twy. Why can't you let me be me, Dad?
How?
This took a turn.
I feel like we've had a real breakthrough here.
I'm locked in.
I mean, if I were like really play acting, I would say because you're a loser, but that would be mean. And my wife has told me to stop being so mean, especially to Devo, because he gets so down on himself when he's behind. So that's why I'm not going to say that loser part.
Thanks.
But rest assured, I'm thinking it.
Tell the wife I said hello.
Okay, let's start with Devo.
Hudson.
Kels?
I also said Hudson.
Why?
Hudson.
And Andy?
Henry Hudson.
It's right there on the river. It's Hudson.
I got the same answer as Kels, but I...
Question three. The first ironclad ship commissioned by the United States Navy was built in Brooklyn. What was its name?
Locked in.
Andy? Just show off. Oh.
Yeah, we could show Dad something now.
There's another reason why I know this, which I'll explain.
It's where Dad sent you to military school. You didn't care enough about me to send me to military school. Now I'm in my own head. You got
your own side quest going over there.
I make myself laugh.
I'm locked in.
All right, let's start with Twy.
Old Ironsides.
Andy.
The Merrimack.
Deva.
I thought it was the Monitor.
Oh, I got it reversed.
You
it
did.
Is the Monitor. Merrimack's Confederacy.
The Enterprise.
Correct answer is the Monitor. Good job, Devo.
Devo.
Thank you.
So what's that reason that you know this one, Andy?
When I was growing up, my grandfather had a houseboat, and he called it the Merrimack.
Oh,
because his Mac Bride, and it's a play on the Merrimack. Nice. And I always thought that was clever.
I didn't know your dad was a Reb.
He was definitely not.
Yeah, all the Rebs in Illinois.
Definitely not.
So I believe, Twi, not to shame nugget you, but I believe it was called Old Ironsides because it withstood a lot of battles, not because it was actually clad in iron.
Oh, yeah, I knew I was wrong. I just went with it. Yeah.
That's a good guess.
What the hell, man?
Hurts, doesn't it, Dave?
It just stings.
Hey, I already said good job. What do you want?
Nothing, Dad. I'm good. And some mashed potatoes, please.
Make sure you eat your green beans.
I hate green beans. I don't eat them.
I don't either. I don't have to eat them, but I'm a grown up.
That was so aggressive. I'm a grown
up. Question four. Where would you find Luna Park and Dino's Wonder Wheel Amusement Park?
Locked in.
Locked in.
Okay. What's your answer? I get it.
Las Vegas.
All right. Devo.
I said Coney Island.
Kells.
Coney Island.
Why?
Coney Island.
Correct answer is Coney Island.
Okay.
So at the end of category six, Andy 115, Devo 140, Kells 173, and Twi 175.
Ooh.
You got me about 2 points. I'm waiting for an answer from one last person.
I don't have it.
All right. So the first and only actual guess, correct guess, I should say, is surprisingly, Kells.
What? I'm glad I'm sitting here.
A movie one?
Hey, Kells, I'm gonna spoil it a little bit here because I have I have a little thing here.
Yeah.
Ladlers. Ladlers. Fight. Come on. Escape from. That is so well done.
So good.
Thank you.
I am definitely saving that audio.
That needs to be archived forever.
Yeah, we are going to use that.
All right, Kels, I'll let you go ahead and walk us through it.
Okay, so I got it after you said it was a cult classic. So that was at halftime.
Right.
So category was... at first I had fights and then I was like, well, it was all baseball too. So I think Baseball Furies.
Mm-hmm.
And the second category was all like K names.
Nope.
It wasn't?
Nope.
That's right. I have.
DJs.
DJ Cool Herc, a radio personality.
DJ Tanner.
DJ Tanner.
From Full House.
And Casey Kasem was a DJ.
Okay.
I would have never fucking gotten DJ Tanner in a million years.
I was still on baseball. I was like K's.
I was totally stuck on baseball because it was all K's, which are strikes.
Yeah, me too. I thought for sure it was a baseball movie. I almost guessed The League of Their Own after Elizabeth.
Someone did guess that.
I came really close.
That was very solid. When you said it's a cult classic, and I said, "Oh, then I'm wrong." I was thinking a League of Their Own.
Mm.
So of course, DJs. The DJ is like the actress or the kind of the narrator,
right?
Lynn Thigpen, right?
Yes. From I know her best from Where in the World Is Carmen Sandiego?
Yep.
Yay. Right.
Yeah.
She was really the DJ from
San Diego.
Yeah. No kidding. I did not know that.
Rockapella, everybody.
That is awesome.
And then category three, it was a gang. Lizzie's.
It
was just the Lizzie's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I never would have gotten this in a million years. I've never seen that movie.
No, I just saw the movie for the first time in the last few years, like 3 years ago, I think. And I enjoyed it, but I would not have remembered all the gang names. I remember the gang themes, sort of. That's about it.
Sort of. I wasn't too sure about category four.
Those were all orphans, books about orphans. Oh. And the one gang was called the Orphans. The gang where they picked up Mercy.
Mm-hmm.
They were called the Orphans.
I forgot about that. Then category five, you got, I saw Swan, Fox, and Rembrandt. They were all members of the Warriors.
Correct. Those are all their gang names.
See, and that's where I went off the rails for me, because I could not come up with category five for anything.
That one actually doesn't make sense unless you know the gang members' names. Right? And I mean, that's really specific information.
Remembered them. Yeah.
And then the last one was New York. And they were trying to get back to Coney Island.
Yep, that's basically the path they took. The conclave that they all met at was in the Bronx. Then they went to Manhattan, and then over to Brooklyn, and then down to Coney Island.
Down to Coney.
Dave-O, you would like this movie. It's worth seeing.
You've never seen The Warriors?
No, I never have.
Oh, man.
It's good.
It's a fun movie. Parts of it are pretty silly, but...
Yes.
Well, it seems like it's very tongue-in-cheek.
It's not, I don't think it was intended to be.
No.
But it's not our quirky. Idea. It's not our idea of what a gang is these days.
Absolutely not. But yeah, it's.
No, I'll give it a watch for
isn't
sure.
Isn't it one of those movies that it's supposed to be in the
future.
Too distant future? Yeah.
Oh, like it's post-apocalyptic?
No. This is more really? Like, this is made in the 70s, and they're like, it'll be like, New York will be like this in the 1990s.
You know,
that kind of
crime has taken over.
Right, exactly. That kind of we're just extending what's happening now a little bit farther.
Okay.
And did you guys know that the novel and the movie are based loosely on Xenophon's Anabasis?
If I knew what that was,
I don't know.
I'd be real impressed.
Blown away.
No, that's. Startling.
So Xenophon is he was an ancient Greek soldier and writer. He was a member of a mercenary group that was hired by Cyrus the Younger to help him seize the throne of Persia. But then Cyrus was killed, which happens at the very beginning of the Warriors. But the 10,000 these mercenaries are like in the middle of Persia and really want to get back home.
So it's the Warriors.
Yeah.
Oh my God. That's insane. That's crazy. Love it.
I'm going to watch this now. Holy crud. That sounds amazing.
Yeah. You'd like this movie. I want to hear what you think.
Excellent mystery though. Honestly.
Yeah, well, thanks. I watched the movie recently and I thought, I could do that. Another thing that I thought was really interesting is there's a guy who used to live in New York City, and he was a site scout, a location scout for movies. And so he knew all of New York very, very well. And he had a website called Scouting New York, I think, where he would go to or go through movies and show where the movies were filmed.
Oh, wow.
And he's got a three part blog post with dozens of pictures of the movie The Warriors and the actual locations where they were filmed. I find that stuff really interesting.
Oh, that's really cool.
Yeah, let's see that.
So Scouting New York, if you want to go check that out.
Yeah.
No escape.
Oh, before we should start, I should probably update the scores. Kells was the only one to get that right. So the scores going into Sudden Death are Andy with 115, Devo 140, Twy 175, and Kells 193. And our Sudden Death theme is Warriors.
Okay.
Question one. The Golden State Warriors have the third most NBA championships. What two teams have more? And you need to get them both.
Really?
Locked in. I didn't realize that they surpassed another team.
Locked in.
I think
locked
that happened in. Just recently.
Yeah, with that last one.
We all locked in? Mm-hmm. I think it's been really quiet.
They've all muted.
Hi, I've been talking a lot.
Yeah.
Kind of weird.
I bet it was really, really interesting too.
Riveting.
Are you locked in?
Yes.
Oh, good. Let's start with Kels.
The Lakers and the Celtics.
Deva?
Lakers and Celtics.
Andy?
Bulls and Lakers. I'm beginning to suspect I'm wrong.
Twy.
Lakers and Celtics?
The correct answer is the Lakers and the Celtics.
What, 17 apiece?
Yeah.
I don't.
Something absurd.
Yeah.
Sorry, Andy.
No, oh, it's, Andy. It's all right. I wish you could keep going with just like half credit.
That was
all night.
Oh, that was my soundboard. That's wrong. Sorry. I'm not going to use that anymore.
Oh, darn. Question two. Who is generally considered the most decorated soldier in U.S. history?
I think Klinger from MASH. He's very decorative.
Locked in.
I'm locked in.
Locked in.
Are we still thinking?
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in.
I'm locked in too.
Okay, sorry.
Deva? I'm not playing anymore because I'm stupid.
That is true. That you're not playing. That you're not playing anymore. Just that you're not playing anymore is what I meant.
God, it hurts. I said Murphy.
That's why.
Captain Crunch.
Oh. Hell yeah.
Kels is the,
give her the points.
In the towel.
You were going to give her anyway.
Kels?
Audie Murphy?
Correct answer is Audie Murphy.
Loved him in Beverly Hills Cop.
I saw people actually debating this because they were like, a lot of his medals aren't as important as ones that other people got. So if you do a weighted average of how important the medals are, there's other screw people that are more decorated. And I'm like,
weighted average. Give me a break.
Yeah. Like a Medal of Honor is worth more. There are people that have gotten two Medals of Honor and two Silver Stars. And he only got one Medal of Honor and two Silver Stars. And
oh,
I'm like,
what a chump.
Yes. God.
All right. So we're down to Kels and Devo. What author was an ambulance driver in World War I, a journalist during the Spanish Civil War, and was present at the Normandy landing and the liberation of Paris?
I want to scream locked in, locked in, locked in. I can't stand it. Daniel Steele. A lot of people would guess that. She was a badass.
I'm not confident at all.
I'm not confident in. Either. I'm locked in.
All right, let's, Kels.
I only went with this because I read Farewell to Arms once, and I said Hemingway.
Deva?
I also said Hemingway.
It is Hemingway.
Hemingway.
What warriors followed the code called Bushido?
Locked in.
Locked in.
Deva?
Samurai.
Kels?
Samurai.
It is samurai. Hippolyta or Hippolyta was a queen of what warrior race?
Locked in.
Locked in.
Kels?
The Amazons.
Deva?
Amazons.
It is the Amazons. Question six. What great Apache warrior rode in Theodore Roosevelt's inauguration parade?
Oh, no.
Locked in.
Get them mixed up. No, this is bad.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat as all of you. I have a guess.
Oh, okay. I'm locked in.
Devo?
Sitting Bull?
Kels?
That's my guess, Devo.
I said Geronimo.
Correct answer? Geronimo.
No! Geronimo!
All right, we're down to Kels.
Good job, Kels.
Thanks, Devo.
All right. Question seven. In the Indian caste system, warriors or kshatriyas were second after what group?
Brahmin?
What was your answer?
Wind and fire.
Brahmin?
I would have accepted priests or Brahmin.
Nice.
Well done, Kells.
Question 8. In the U.S. military, what elite group of soldiers wear no insignia on duty and no rank insignia on duty and spend their days walking 21 paces back and forth with 21 second pauses between each maneuver?
The soldiers that guard the tomb of the unknown soldier. I feel either really dumb or the call drop.
Yeah, I'm just, this is a weird, this is the longest pause ever.
Sorry, I muted myself.
Oh. God, there was so much shame there. I'm bad. Sorry, you're gonna have to give me a minute, Neil.
I'm just gonna have to walk. It's
overwhelming shame.
I think I coughed or something and I muted myself. Oh. The correct answer is the guard of the tomb of the unknown soldier.
Hells is rocking this thing, man.
What? Why was that funny?
No, it's that was the right answer. And I'm sitting over here like, oh, I just said the dumbest thing.
We've been sweating that for a while.
Sorry. It's like, I hope I just lost internet.
No, since they don't know who the soldiers buried there are, they don't know who they are. They don't want to outrank them. So that's why they don't wear rank insignia. Oh, okay. That's a pretty hardcore job.
That's
if you ever read about awesome. What they do, and it's, they take it very seriously.
As they should.
And in fact, what I didn't realize, I thought there was just the World War II soldier there. Or was it one?
No.
It's there's they more had than Korean. Well, there, yeah. So there was a Vietnamese or Vietnam War soldier there, but somebody did a bunch of research and figured out who that was. So they actually interred them and did a DNA test and found out that they identified him. And then they removed him and sent him back to where his family wanted him. And then, so there is no Vietnam soldier there. They put plaque or something there to All right. So question 9, what is the nickname given to a woman in the Revolutionary War who carried water to soldiers and took the place of her fallen husband as a cannoneer during the Battle of Monmouth?
I'm out.
Oh, give me a minute.
It's a nickname.
Yeah. I can see the famous painting of her. We almost shit the bed in the Battle of Monmouth.
I'm sorry?
What?
Hamilton.
What?
It's a line from Hamilton. God, you heathens. It's a musical. It hasn't gotten a lot of airplay. I don't expect you guys to have heard of it. Yeah. It's a little thing. I want to play a little theater there on Broadway for a bit.
I got nothing. Howling Commando. I have no idea.
Hey. Wow.
I want that action figure.
Is that correct?
Yeah,
no. The water is significant that she carried water.
Water bear?
No.
Not
the Molly.
Is that Molly?
Molly Pitcher.
Oh no! I don't think it would have taken me a long time to get there.
Okay.
I don't know if I would have pulled that.
She had ecstasy. No wonder we fought so well.
Passionate fighting.
So Kel's out, but let's do our final question real quick. What Frankish warrior king was promoted to emperor in Rome in 800 AD?
Charlemagne.
It was Charlemagne.
Nice. Nice.
Okay, our final scores then are Andy with 115. Twy 185, Devo 190, and Kells 273 points.
Wow, Kells.
Man.
Excellent work, my man.
Thank you. Thank you. Great game, all.
Yeah. So if you liked this quiz, this mystery quiz, but think, hey man, I can do better. Write run yourself and send it in.
Tonight. The challenge. Easy.
You sound like you're threatening them.
No, what? Write one.
You can do better. Just fucking write one yourself, asshole.
He has a gun.
And when you get that one written, send it in to Neil at brainladle.com. He'll look it over and see if it reaches his high sensei standards. Right, so please.
I haven't checked my email in like 2 weeks.
Oh, Jesus.
If you've already done what Dave told you to do, you don't need to.
Clearly,
reply.
The urgency is not there, but we do appreciate it. We like it when you do it. So, Neil at brainladle.com for all your quizzes, your suggestions for quiz topics, anything like that. So, from all of us here at the Brain Ladle Trivia Podcast, this is your MC Davo with Kells.
60,000 soldiers. There ain't but 20,000 police in the whole town. Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
I can't believe you memorized Cyrus's speech, too.
I love that part.
Why?
John, Cheyenne, Stephanie, Lee, Tamara, Ian, Nancy, Asha, Alex, J.S. Caboose, Joel, Ice Cream Boy, Nabs, and the Sifu Berry, we want to extend our deepest gratitude to each and every one of you for joining us during our live event. Your support means the world to us, and it's because of patrons like you that we're able to continue creating and sharing our passion with the world.
Andy.
Is she talking about our show?
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. So long, little brainers.
And the Sensei Neil.
Latest sports news off the street boppers. The baseball furies dropped the ball, made an error. Our friends are on second base and trying to make it all the way home. But the inside word is that the odds are against them. Stay tuned, boppers. Stay tuned.
Holy crap, that was Kermit San Diego.
It is. Well, that, no, that's not actually that. Carmen San Diego.
No, the lady from Carmen San Diego. Signing off.
In a world haunted by violence and depravity, a new voice rises above the rest.
It's a me.
What happens when a strong, sassy woman goes up against three immature boys that are made all the more uncomfortable by strong, sassy women?
No. No. It's not true. It's impossible.
But it is. And with your Patreon support, we can continue this stupid, stupid saga. Who knows? Maybe one of these guys will surprise Twi.
You truly belong here with us, among the clouds.
Nope.
Hey! Swing and a miss.
You just committed a felony.
I just killed Twi.
You killed Twi.
Oh,
God.
You got...
Oh. The hay was well timed.
It's gotta be totally random. Like you're watching a different boss baseball game while you're calling this one. Because sometimes there'd be nothing going on the field. Hey! Look at the sombrero on that kid, Stoney.
He was a bit of an alcoholic.
He had a problem.
He had a problem.
We ready?
All right, hold on. I want to look up when Marty Bradman.
Are you serious?
Well, I'm just curious. I want to see when Marty. I'm sure I'm right. Marty Bradman.
He looked it up in the background since I please continue.
Well,
nobody else is on pins and needles about Marty Bradman.
All right. I won't look it up.
No, look it up. I want you to continue your research. You know, I want the game to keep
going. No rain delays.
Brain delays.
Yeah, Yeah, he was in the 2000s. There was a Cubs manager once that had a fight with a desk. That's a good fight.
Hal McCray?
Hal McCray. Yeah,
that was classic.
That is epic. He took out the desk.
Destroyed that office.
In a press conference. It was beautiful.
He was that phone toss and twirl. Oh, used to have me in fits.
You know, and you remember when Big Poppy got the bad call in Baltimore and went off and destroyed the bullpen phone with a bat?
Yeah, yeah.
Just obliterated it. Well, when he retired, they gave him that phone mounted on a plaque.
Your phone's ringing and you don't have a bat. That's a problem.
That's a problem.
Fat man weed is killing dope.
You know, the only impression I can do is Tina Turner introducing Bryan Adams.
Oh. Well, hey.
I mean, it's damn good, though.
Have you heard this yet, Twy?
No. Dave, are you muted?
Yeah, he's been muted for a while. Close your eyes, Twy.
I'm not muted.
Oh. Okay.
Why?
Because close Emily just sent me a message and asked me if we could hear Felix caterwauling over Davo's mic. I guess Felix is
caterwauling. That's funny.
That's what she said.
Anybody that works the phrase caterwauling into a sentence is awesome in my book. She wins.
She does not get paid enough for what she does.
Right? That is right.
Okay, Andy, I'm sorry. Go ahead with your story. That's all right.
Well, I'm going to do something special for you. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Imagine you're hanging out with Tina Turner and her friend Bryan Adams shows up. And she turns to you and says, Bryan Adams.
It almost sounds like a trumpet when you do it. I don't know how you do it.
Bryan Adams!
Neil, can you repeat the question, please?
I can.
Will you?
Oh, yeah.
Such an asshole.
This is asking the right questions, class. You gotta ask the right questions. You know
what? What fictional. My wife hates it when I do that.
The Hanna-Barbera theme park that I'm not aware of?
It's D-E-N-O.
It's in Jellystone Park.
When your parents get afford Disney World, you go to Hanna-Barbera World.
Let's ride the McGill Gorilla.
Don't go to the El Cabong exhibit. You get hit with a guitar.
Come here, kids. El Cabong.
Captain Caveman, all of them.
Captain Caveman is a classic.
Hong Kong Fooey. It's a classic.
Hong Kong Fooey is also a classic. That's why how I learned a lot about Asian culture.
Yeah. Hong Kong Fooey.
You know, I just really, it just occurred
really
to me.
Opened my eyes.
It just occurred to me that Hong Kong Fooey is voiced by Scatman Crothers.
Crothers.
So, like, yeah.
Hell yeah. That guy was doing the Asian dogs.
Again, he just threw Kung Fu.
He's an Asian dog.
He wasn't an Asian dog. He was a janitor dog who fought crime.
Now that I think about it, the premise is
troubling. It's just troubling.
It's troubling.
Don't deconstruct it because he's a janitor, man. He hid his costume in a closet.
What a catchy theme song.
I thought his costume was in a filing cabinet.
It was. It was in the filing cabinet near the.
I think
it was a red gi.
It was a red gi and a domino mask.
Mighty Mouse was a janitor. I think, or a street sweeper, wasn't he?
He was a janitor because he had a bucket and a mop in an office building.
No, he's talking. He said Mighty Mouse.
So I said Mighty Mouse. Was it Mighty Mouse a janitor or a street sweeper or something?
I'm not up on my Mighty Mouse lore.
Hmm. Well, the market was kind of tough back then. I don't think he had a job.
Yeah, it was. It was
hard times.
I never saw a Mighty Mouse cartoon.
I'm sorry. Be honest with you. Oh, I've seen all of them. Are you kidding me?
Back when you could watch them all for a nickel. In between the newsreels.
Neil, could you repeat the question?
Are you serious?
It was so long ago.
It was 5 minutes ago.
I know.
Man, when I first saw that movie when I was like 12, 13 years old, when she came on the screen, I was just entranced. Because you only see her from like her nose down.
Mm-hmm.
And she's talking to that microphone, and man, that was so sexy.
She got the voice.
Yeah.
This works.
Luscious lips.
Okay, then.
Wow. Oh shit, I should have stopped recording.
Sign off.
I thought I did. No, I'm glad we left it.
No, dear God, it's all on there now.
We cut that part out, right?
Luscious Lips is gonna be on on the air.
It's awful. And you told them to stay tuned, so they were listening.
Stay tuned, Bappas.
The preceding podcast was presented by Brain Ladle Productions. All rights reserved.
Ladlers, come out to play. Ladlers, come out to play.
Sure, come get this baby.